So that's now the white cable connected to pin 51 on the ECU. So this is just another billion cables to connect.
Cool.
Your head is full of dreams. Tears are a proof of failure. You just gotta let them flow without judge. There's so many ways to be happy. You can do whatever you like. You don't have to be ready. You just gotta trust the right.
Hi there, guys. Welcome to another episode. In the last episode, I fitted the injection parts to the engine. So the next step really is to get the wiring all put in, to get the ECU fitted, battery fitted, fuel pump relay, power relay, fuse boxes, that sort of thing. So that is what we're going to do today.
What I have found out afterwards, and just a little tip, that I took this connector straight off of the Escort. I also got the engine loom here, and well, I chopped that off as well. What I've found out since then is that these cables go directly into these cables. So if I'd have took more time and taken this plug off and then follow all the wires back, I would have got to this connector. And what would have saved me so much time now is that I would have been able to just take off the wires I don't need, sort out the wires that I do need, and it's basically plug and play after that. So I found that out the hard way.
So what you're going to need is an ECU like this one.
This ECU comes from a Mondeo. You can't, or you can, take any ECU you want off of an early Mark 1 Mondeo. My recommendations are that you look for this. So what you need to look for really is these four words on here. So there's Dewey, Desk, and Deep. These three particular ECUs are the Ford, and it does say there, these particular ECUs are the Ford EEC4, or the EEC4. These are non-PATS. Now, PATS is a system that Ford have used for quite a while, and it's called Passive Anti-Theft System. And basically what it means is, to start the engine, you need the key, which has got a little chip in it, and it's got a little ring around the ignition. If you have the right chip in your key, it reads it with the ring and it sends it to this module. If it's then the right chip for this module, the engine will start. If it's the wrong chip for the module, the engine won't start. Dewey, Desk and Deep, they don't have PATS in them. So this doesn't have an immobilizer fitted to it. So it makes it a lot easier for this system. If you don't use the Dewey, Deep or Desk modules like this one, then you will have to get an additional part of the wiring loom, which goes up to the key and has got the ring around the key, and then you'll also need the key for that car. Basically, all you'd need to do is tape the key to the ring so that it's always there, and it'll start the car. But it's an additional part that you need. I think there are companies out there that will program away the PAT system, but if you've got the key in the ring, then you don't need to worry about it. Now, I've got the cable here. This is the 60 pin cable, as opposed to the one that came off of the Mondeo that is 100 pin. And as you can see, it's got four rows of pins, and the 60 has only got three rows of pins. This one, 100 pins, will not fit that ECU because that's only got 60 pins on it. So make sure you get the right connector to the right ECU. Now, in places like Bobcat, Project Bobcat, I'll put a link down below, there is a wiring diagram and a wiring guide to this. I've basically gone along that wiring diagram and taken out any of the pins that I don't need. Right, so just thought I'd show you how to pull the pins out of this connector. And basically, you need to get a little bit of a, I've got a, like a, looks like a dentist tool really. Put it in one of these holes here and we'll start to prise out this bit of locking plastic here. Like that, eventually it'll be out far enough and you can just take it out. So I'm going to take out this top pin here because I don't need it anymore. So I've got these tools here. I bought them off of, I don't know, I bought them a long time ago, eBay, Amazon, something like that. But there's loads of different tools here for poking pins out. So I'm going to be using something like that one, I think. That one there, slightly pointed one at the end there, just so I can get in the plastic here. And I'll basically slide it along there where the pin should be, and a little wiggle, and it'll basically just prise open that plastic slightly enough for me to pull the cable out like that. Just felt it click, so I can take my tool out and the pin just pulls out like that. So that's how to get the pin out of that plastic. So once you've got your pin out, all you have to do is put this piece of plastic back in again and just push it back down again, and that just stops the little plastic clip that holds the pin in place. So that's how to pull the pins out of the 60 pin connector.
What I will show you now is how I've connected the cables together. I'm using this kind of a connector. Basically you just put the cables in from either end, heat up with a heat gun, and it melts, and in the middle there you'll see a little bit of solder that melts onto the wires and melts them together. And they're really quite strong, so I recommend these. These are really, really good.
So that's now the white cable connected to pin 51 on the ECU. So this is just another billion cables to connect.
Right, before we move over to the relays and stuff, I just want to say, press that subscribe button, don't forget it. It really does help my channel to grow, and you obviously don't want to miss the information about Alice, do you? So press that subscribe button, press the bell, you won't miss anything. Right, let's crack on with these relays.
So before we go into any kind of wiring diagrams, I just wanted to show you basic simple steps of how a relay works. Now this is a 4-pin relay. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 pins on here. And basically it's two separate switches. So we've got one switch here, and this switch activates that switch, which is the second switch. So we've got one switch, two switches. So this is the feed, the low side of the relay. And basically, as you can see, we've got 12 volt coming in that is switched. So whenever you want to switch something on, if you're going to use lights or anything like that, as soon as you switch the lights on, you'll put power through that coil and then out to earth. So pin 85 and 86 can be wired in either way around. It doesn't matter, as long as the power goes through this coil here. So you've got a switch 12 volt there and an earth going out there. What this does is makes this coil here, because it's a coil winding of wires, makes it magnetic, and it pulls this little wire here. So that pulls that and makes that a closed circuit, and allowing the 12 volt straight from the battery to go to here. As you can see, until we activate the relay, the power will only go that far. It won't go any further. So there's power in all the time, permanent feed, but we're not going to activate it until we activate this coil, which makes this magnetic and joins 80, 30 and 87 together. And that is your output. So whatever you feed in is out there. This is how I've connected it in. I've not fully tested it yet, so don't take my word for it. I'm not an auto electrician by any means. If you're unsure about doing this, then please ask somebody for help. So this is just a diagram I've made, simply, and I've taken it from the diagrams that I've been following, which I've got from it's like a Haynes manual basically, and I've adapted it from there to fit the car. So I'm going to go through each pin. So from pin 30 on the power relay, we're going to take a feed out here to the coil. That's the middle pin of the coil. The other two pins that come out of here go back to the ECU. Coming out the bottom of the fuel pump relay, we've got another fuse and then onto the fuel pump, and that also feeds pin 8. Now the reason for this one
is that when you turn the ignition on, you'll get a power on there, which builds up the pressure. And then when you start the car, it gets the feed from the relay. Confused me a bit to start with, but that's what it is. Pin 86 is an earth from the ECU. Pin 86 on this side is again another earth, and that goes direct to the chassis or to the battery, it's up to you. Pin 87, which is out from here, now this one, according to the diagram, does feed all of these components. So we've got the injectors, we've got pin 37 and pin 57 of the ECU, we've got the speed sensor, which is attached to the gearbox, we've got the mass airflow sensor on there, and the lambda sensor. Now I've added an extra fuse in for the lambda sensor. What I've also done is taken the mass airflow and the lambda sensor and attached them to that pin. No, sorry, to that pin. Just to split the load up on these two relays. So I've only got the speed sensor, the ECU and the injectors on one relay, and I've got the mass airflow and the lambda on the other relay. So as you can see, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fuses fitted, and this is roughly how I fitted it.
So on paper, that's how you wire the fuel pump and the power relay and a set of fuses. So this is how mine looks in reality. So I've fitted them to the bulkhead there. It still looks a bit of a mess because I've not quite tied it up yet, but I've got the wires coming here from the battery and going to the fuel pump. And then basically these wires up here are the ones that go to the ECU. But these are the ones that go at the moment to the relays and the fuses. So what I want to do now is crank the car over, make sure that the fuel pump turns on and turns off as it should do, meaning it's getting a signal from the ECU. Then I want to check for a spark, and basically I need to wire in the fuel lines, and hopefully the engine will start very, very shortly. But that's going to be another video. And the reason for that is I've got some other stuff I want to get done as well at the same time as I wire in the fuel lines. So that'll be the next video. So keep your eyes open for that. If you like what you've seen in this video and you want to see, hopefully, the start of the engine very, very shortly, press that subscribe button, press the bell so you don't miss it. And then I'll see you in the next video. Thanks a lot, and bye-bye.